It's time for the Italian Grand Prix once again, here at the beloved and iconic Autodromo Nazionale di Monza. With the lowest downforce and drag of any circuit in the season, expect to see drivers making the most of the slipstream effect here today. With top speeds up to 215 miles per hour and an average lap speed of around 155 miles per hour, Monza's reputation as one of the fastest circuits in the sport is well earned. We have 11 corners on this 3.6 mile track, with the best overtaking chance coming into the heavy braking zone of the Turn 1 chicane. Anthony Davidson is here once again for today's Grand Prix. Let's talk about O'Connor. That was a great win in the last race. Can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
It's always nice to come into a Grand Prix weekend on a high, but your expectations are based much more on your practice and qualifying runs. So it's the momentum from those sessions that they'll be hoping to carry into the race today.
It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Gasly, Esteban Ocon, and Perez, Stroll, Ricciardo, Norris, and Max Verstappen, Sainz, Kvyat, Romain Grosjean, and Albon, Vettel, Russell, Kimi Raikkonen, and Antonio Giovinazzi, Schumacher, Magnussen, Latifi, and O'Connor. Now, it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Jeff here, radio check. Check, check, can you hear me? Okay, we had a fantastic result at the last race. Let's try it again here.
Taking some minor damage. is available on the MFD. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green. Exit now. You'll be racing as you leave the pits. Exit. Exit now. Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tires.
you up the place.
Seconds. Seconds. fastest lap of the race. Clear. the race. Gap to car in front is 2.6 seconds. This is your final lap of the race. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. The end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
So Mercedes have won it, and what a great race it was. Tell me, Ant, how did they manage to achieve this win?
Well, this was a real team victory. They put together a solid strategy today that appeared well suited to the conditions out on track. The driver did everything that was expected of them in the moment to really execute the team's plan to perfection, a shining example of how F1 really is a team sport.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it. Let's have a quick look at how the driver standings have changed. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. Let's focus on the driver of the day, Anthony Davidson. Who do you pick?
I have to give it to O'Connor. There was a lot going on all down the field, but they were the only one who I really felt maximised their potential.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.